Now let's see a question. How can you make a chemical equation more informative? For that, first of all, we have to add physical state. Add physical state with formula. So with the formula, we have to add the physical state of the reactants and the products. For that, if it is a solid, we can add S. If it is a liquid, we can add L. If it is a gas, we can add G. And also, if it is an aqueous solution, we can add AQ in bracket. Aqueous means solution in water. So, solution in water is called an aqueous solution. If it is a solution in water, we can add AQ in bracket. So, we have to add the physical state with the formula. While writing the formula, we can add the physical state of the reactants and the products. If it is a solid, we can add S in bracket. If it is a liquid, L in bracket. If it is a gas, G in bracket. If it is a solution in water, we can call it as aqueous solution. And we have to add AQ in bracket. Then, second point is, we have to indicate the reaction condition. The reaction conditions like temperature, pressure, catalyst, etc. above or below the arrow. So this is the second point. So we can indicate the reaction conditions like temperature, pressure, catalyst, etc. above or below the arrow of the chemical equation. Let's see some examples. So consider these equations. We can make these equations more informative by adding the physical state and the reaction conditions. So let us see the first equation. Zn plus H2SO4 gives ZnSO4 plus H2. So Zn zinc, that is a solid. You know it's a solid. We can add S here. H2SO4 is an aqueous solution. We can add AQ in bracket. Then ZnSO4 zinc sulfate is also aqueous. It's a solution in water. H2, you know it's a gas. So we have made this equation more informative by adding the physical state of the reactants and the products. So in this case, carbon monoxide and hydrogen produces methanol. So this is actually methanol. It's an alcohol. So carbon monoxide, you know, it's a gas. We can write G. H2 also, it's a gas. And CH3OH, it is methanol. It's an alcohol. It is a liquid. So we can write liquid L here. And there is a reaction condition, that is 300 atm. And 300 degrees C. That means we have indicate the pressure and temperature above and below the arrow. So 300 atmosphere means 300 atmospheric pressure. So this reaction takes place at this particular temperature and this particular pressure. That means 300 atmosphere and 300 degrees Celsius. So we have indicated the reaction conditions like pressure and temperature. Then consider the next equation, KClO3, potassium chlorate, that is a solid. KCl, that is also a solid. And O2, oxygen, it is a gas. So we have indicate the physical states of the reactants and products, reactant and products. In this case, we can write a symbol like this. So this symbol actually represents heat. So, if you are heating this KClO3, we will get these products. For that, we have drawn like this. So, this indicates heat. And one more thing we are adding, that is MnO2. So, MnO2 on or above or below the arrow. That indicates this MnO2 is a catalyst. So this MnO2 here acts as a catalyst. MnO2 here acts as a catalyst. Catalyst means it is which influence the rate of reaction. So a catalyst influence the rate of reaction. So the reaction rate or the speed of the reaction can be increased by adding a catalyst. That is the meaning of catalyst. So that catalyst also can be written in the arrow. So that is another point to be noted while making the reaction more informative. For making the reactions more for making chemical equations more informative, we can add the physical state. First point is the states, physical state, and second point is reaction condition. So these are the two points to be noted while writing a chemical equation for making it more informative.